big hello and welcome to everyone who's tuned in. You know, when we sent out promotional mailers for today's discussion on to shoot or not to shoot, someone called Ivy, who heads a line production company, wrote to me. She said that shooting on the ground has been like dancing among corona landmines for her crew. And that line, I felt, summed up the theme of today's discussion really, really well. Especially with a lot of mixed opinions within the industry about allowing ad shoots and film shoots to resume after both the Bachchans contracted the virus. So to discuss that today on Creative Talks, which will be streamed live across Facebook, Twitter and LinkedIn, we have very prominent personalities from the ad and film industry. For a change, let me start with the youngest. We have Anushka Sen, actor and influencer, better known as Mani Karnika from the TV serial Jhansi Ki Rani. She's 18 years old and has 9.1 million followers on Instagram. Anushka, you're giving us some major social media goals there. Then we
Thank you so much. Then we have
Puneet Malhotra, producer Dharma 2.0, which is Karan Johar's production house that exclusively focuses on creating ad films. Puneet also has directed popular films like Student of the Year 2 and I Hate Love Stories. Hi, Puneet.
Hi, Ray.
We also have Agnello Dias, creative chairman of Dentsu Ages Network. He's also the co-founder of Taproot Dentsu, which literally gave every big agency a run for its money, even in its nascent years. We have Arun Iyer, founding partner, Spring Marketing Capital, who, according to me, has made the most viral lockdown video ad featuring Sumit Vyas as the bichara husband tortured into doing household work by his wife. Hi, Arun.
Hey, Neeta. Nice to be here.
And lastly, we have Anshuman Chakravarti, head marketing, brand and corporate communications at Orient Electric, one of the most active advertisers in the country today. And his brand has also been endorsed by MS Dhoni for many years now. So welcome to Creative Talks, everyone.
Let me start
with Aggie. Aggie, after the Bachchan scare and the shutting down of the studio where AB Jr. had dubbed for his web series, many prominent film personalities like Shekhar Kapoor have come out to say that it's dangerous to start filming in closed interior spaces. Studios will become huge sources of infection. Do you agree?
I agree with what he's saying, but I don't agree with the fact that it should stop, because I don't think there's ever going to be a point where we are going to be able to say, yes, now it is safe to start shooting. So one of the misnomers of the lockdown is that everybody is waiting to see there. And the feeling is that when the lockdown is lifted, coronavirus will go away, because that is a sign that it's gone. So I think we'll have to learn to live with it. Ironically, as it turns out with Mr. Bachchan and his son, probably if they were shooting, they may have not got it because they could have got it from home. So I don't know whether the solution any longer is to kind of avoid it. We may have reached a stage where the only solution is to go through it and not around it or go backward, because if it's going to be a lockdown for the next 1 year or so, then it anyway makes no sense. So shooting will resume, I think, but with greater care and greater cost, and that's what will happen.
Now let me come to you, Puneet. For you and Dharma 2.0, it must have hit even closer home. Ad shoots were halted for 2 full months. Do you think we should step back and evaluate the risk further before going all out at the first given opportunity?
I mean, it's a bit of a tricky question, because you are going to have to evaluate the risks. It's but like Aggie said, you got to step out of home at some point. So I don't believe in sitting at home and waiting for the pandemic to pass. That's never going to happen. You got to go out. You got to just really actually value the risk, see what's whether you have anything to lose, if I may say so, at that point in time. How safe can you be? How safe is your crew? How safe is everybody on set? These are really important questions, and these are the only questions that we kind of need to answer. Given those parameters, if you can manage to pull off a shoot, I don't think there's any reason that we should be sitting at home. As long as everybody's safe, you follow government norms, and you go ahead and do the right thing, I think you can go out and shoot. Why not?
Arun, tell me what apprehensions from prominent film personalities would mean for the advertising industry. You know, at the moment, we are hearing people largely talk about wanting to stop shoots of TV series, web series, and films. No one has really spoken much about, you know, ads, even though it technically follows the same process. What do you think?
Yeah, no, I think there's a reason for that, why that's happening also, is because be it web series or films or TV stuff, it's longer durations of shoot, right? So it's many, many days of groups of people coming together. Versus in an ad film shoot, it is groups of people but coming together for a short while. It's a lot more, you know, you can control the environment a lot better. So I guess that's the reason. But that said, I think I agree with Aggie and Puneet. I think it is risky. Of course, we are living in a risky world. You've got to measure your risk. You've got to make sure that only people who absolutely have to be there have to be there. Earlier we were used to. And Indian sets are very famous for just carrying along hordes of people, right? There would be 300-400 people on a set where actually the number of people you actually need would only be about 20 or 25. I think today it's getting rationalized to what it should have been anyways, where only the people who absolutely have to be there are getting out there and doing the work. So I guess this is the new reality, and we have to, like I agree with Aggie and Puneet, we have to now find a way to work around this, because we can't all be sitting at home and not do anything, right?
Now, Anshuman, as a marketer, what is your perspective? Should we go back to the lockdown ads mode, shot exclusively in a work from home, setup, or embrace whatever little normalcy the world has to offer with restrictions?
Well, I couldn't agree more to what Agnello, Arun and Puneet talked about. We have to resume life. Yeah, I was saying that while there cannot be any further agreement what Agnello, Arun and Puneet talked about, life has to resume and we have to live life with COVID. And these scenarios are tough scenarios. We'll have to find ways how to manage the crisis and how to restart working. As clients, we are also finding new ways of working. We do understand that we'll have to find new creative angles, whether to revise scripts in a way which can be shot easily without much complexities, trying to work with not celebrities, but junior artists where things are much more easier to control, having much more control at the sets where we do not want many, many people to loiter around, and various other things that have come up. And I must appreciate the fact that the Producers Guild came up with the notification of 15th of March, and they decided to stop the shooting of 19, which was a very proactive step from the Producers Guild. And they also came out with a complete list of SOPs, which are very, very detailed. And I think that's the right step and approach to tackle this current scenario.
Okay. And lastly, Anushka, you worked in 20 commercials, 8 TV shows, a couple of mainstream films too. You know, as an actor, what are your thoughts? Because at the end of the day, I think actors are, most vulnerable. They have to shoot without any protection, while, the rest of the crew can wear masks, gloves, PPE kits, whatever. But you can't. So what do you think about getting back out there?
I think it's been 4 months since I, went out of my house. I've not seen my door only. And I really miss shooting and everything. I think just like Arun sir said, TV shows or web series take a long time, even to start a new TV show, the mock shoots, the dress trials and the launch. And there's always a rush because, they have to create banks in order to, launch it as soon as possible, whenever the launch date is. So I think if I'm looking at shooting right now in this situation, what I would think is I would not start with TV serials and web series for now. But to some extent, I think I would do movies. I would be open to do ads or music videos because it requires less number of people. And just like you said, actors are the most vulnerable people right now, because there's no mask, there's no safety when you're shooting. But if this precaution taken, and if we are careful about, if we're following the rules, I think we'll be safe, and we'll probably be out of the risk area. I think the most important part is not panicking and following the the rules and norms which is there. If the set is fully with precautions and people are there to take responsibility and everyone around is, you know, with the PPE suit. So I think actors will be also safe. And yeah, that would be my thing to look at right now.
That said, I just want to say one thing. I don't know. There was an image of a TV actor with a shield actually acting, which
yeah.
doing the rounds, right? Which was doing the rounds, because I think they kind of wove it into the story and they let the character have the shield on within the serial itself. It was quite a moment.
So do you think we can weave the reality in these commercials and these TV series, you know, get these actors to wear all those masks on the sets?
Not all the time, but I think in some context it does make sense, right? If the storyline itself lends itself to the current context, you can do that.
Arun, okay. I also saw a television commercial recently. I think it's a lubricant brand, and the artist in that TVC also were wearing visors. So it's getting a fairly common norm, and people are experimenting to show the new normal in an artistic way.
Yeah, sure.
You know, Puneet.
It's a matter of time. I'm guessing someone makes a movie about this as well. No, it's going to happen. Happen really soon.
Ram Gopal Verma is my guess.
You know, Puneet, you are going to be shooting an ad for Kurkure. I think you mentioned. Day after tomorrow. I'd like you to take our viewers through what has changed on the ground post-lockdown. You know, in terms of how you shoot an ad, the size of the crew and the entire process.
I think like Arun said, a lot has changed. We normally had about 100, 150 people conventionally on a set, even if you were shooting an ad. It's gone down to 30, 40. That's the crew strength at this point of time. So you reduced it to really, you know, one third or one fifth in that sense. Food is going to be packed. Most people are not going to be touching being served in the catered boxes. The BMC has its own norms, so the whole place is sanitized. I think from the producer's point of view, what shakes up the cost completely is that our setting days, increase in a major way. There's a COVID insurance that's coming that you have to actually get in place. So on every level, there's a practical hurdle that you kind of need to combat. And I think that's what's getting a little tricky. But I'm guessing it's the new norm. You know, like you started off saying on this is either fight it or you just sit at home. I think we are all in a mood to fight it because everybody's done sitting at home at this point of time.
So I think the real test, right now we're all confident and, you know, optimistic and all that. But the first real test will come, and it will come, when somebody from a shooting set actually gets COVID. Then how do we react? Does everybody panic and run helter-skelter? Or do the naysayers come back and say, shut down everything again? Or do we hold our ground and say, look, this could happen anyway. So, and let's continue doing what we do. So that will be, and that's going to happen sooner or later. It's not, despite all the precautions and everything we do, sooner or later, somebody from some set will get it. And the reaction of us as an industry will determine how we go forward. So far, it is all going to be fine because we'll be, you know, fighting. But when that happens, which voice prevails in the industry is going to decide actually the long-term future of the industry.
I completely agree, Agnolo. In fact, the only assumption that I have in mind is that the reactions to these are also changing dramatically. Had this episode happened 2 months ago, people would have reacted differently. But now, I think people are also maturing to the fact that we have to live with this virus and the pandemic effect on life and work. So I think the reactions are also getting gradually mature to the fact that we realize that something of this nature might happen to any of us.
Makes sense. You know, Abhi, as an agency,
I think Puneet is trying to say something.
Okay. Go on.
I think personally and genuinely, I think ad films are at an advantage with this kind of a setup. Because if you do manage to get COVID on an ad set, no one will ever know. The advantage is that you shoot for a day and then the team pretty much disembarks and everybody's, you know, on their own. As opposed to a film shoot or a TV serial shoot where your schedules are much longer. So let's say I'm on set tomorrow and I manage to contract the disease from someone. By the time I'm diagnosed, it may be between 4 or 7 days. By then your, you know, set is dismantled and everybody's moved on. So you can never really trace it back to an ad shoot in all reality. So in that sense, it's a bit of an advantage. But having said that, you still need to be as safe as you can.
Yeah, but that still puts you at risk, right? Even if you can't trace it back to that particular ad. So
I just wanted to check. Imagine getting it on a shoot of a face mask COVID ad. But I just wanted to check with Puneet, in these cut down crews and larger crews, how are the unions taking it? Do you still have to pay what would have been the original crew? Because normally unions would react strongly to that, where you're actually cutting down on employment by reducing, say, the crew with the lights and with everything.
No, I'm guessing it's a norm that's actually come from the BMC. So, we are not liable to do any of that. I also think there's genuinely a labor problem in Mumbai and around. So there's not so much labor in the first place. I know there are tons of people who are unemployed, and I mean, it's really unfortunate, and people are trying to help them in whatever way that, they can. But no, I don't think there's a union problem at this point of time. In fact, it's working the other way right now. If you have more people on set, you may get penalized. Okay. So I think that's...
Anushka, do you feel safer going back on the set after what Puneet said?
I think, yeah, because, even I think that some point of time we have to go out, and ad shoots, I might still, go right now, because see, this thing is going on since 4 months, and I don't know how long, we have to wait. If we wait till the time the government says, okay, now there's zero cases. So the best part about, the positive part about coronavirus is that in India, at least, that the recovery rate is 70% more than the, people who are getting affected. Of course, the death rate is also people are also catching coronavirus at 30,000 per day, which is, very scary. But the recovery rate is also very... very positive, and I think very healthy. So I think panic should be not there. And of course, it's very tricky to shoot right now and very scary. You have to always be, wondering that, oh my God, should I trust this? Should I do that? Should I not do this? Should I walk here or not? But I think right now we have to, see that, take the odds, and we have to just shoot with, utmost precaution and less number of people.
Arun, I'd like to bring you in here. We spoke about, how you're shooting a bunch of ads in the coming few days. Tell me, are you scripting ads now, keeping in mind the social distancing norms, less scripts needing a lot of people, or close contact between characters? Literally, are scripts getting adapted to the pandemic now?
No, not anymore, Neeta. Actually, this was the case of maybe 2 months back. When we were in the thick of it, we didn't know when it would open up and stuff. I think the world has moved from there. For how long, I don't know. Because in this new world, one thing we have to be very ready for is things can change completely in 2 days from now. As of today, at this point in time, things are looking like of course, it's a lot of effort. Like, we just finished something where we shot in 4 cities. And there were 4 crews. So there were 4 DOPs, 4 cameramen who shot in 4 cities, and we had to stitch everything together. Now, so it is challenging, but that said, as of today, there is a reverse push on, let it not look like there are constraints. Let's try and look as far as possible to make it seem as normal as possible. So of course there are, you do think 4 times before saying, okay, let's have an outdoor shot like this. You don't write outdoor shots very easily. You think of indoor spaces. The thing is, and I think Aggie said this a couple of times, some time ago, said our wiring and way of thinking has changed. And we will know the full impact of it maybe in the future. But as of today, the way we think, because we do, and I think that's true of creative people, right? You think with the environment in mind. And I think that's something that's going on. We are all very aware of what the environment is. So you do think and write, keeping all of those things in mind. But just a long answer to your short question of, are we thinking only with the lockdown kind of images? No, we are not.
Anshuman, even you have recently shot for a new innovative orient product. As a marketer, what are the hurdles you had to cross during the shoot? Additional precautions or something that you had to take?
Yeah, so our planning started sometime last month. And during that phase, we faced a lot of challenges because shooting was not allowed and there were a lot of restrictions all around. But finally, we could, when the lockdown opened up, we could find ways to do the shoot because we had a new product to be launched this month on 18th. So there were challenges and we couldn't go out. We had to figure out a solution in Delhi. So that was one. We had a lot of restrictions on how do we write the script so that there's less of human interaction as much as possible and how to minimize it, make it non-celebrity, do not construct a set. So those are the restrictions that were put into the entire scheme of things. So I think that puts a lot of pressure on the creative side to deliver something. And that was the biggest challenge that we had. The second was that while we do not want to compromise on quality, how do we ensure that we get the same level of output with less number of equipment and men behind the DOP working for it? So those were the typical challenges that were there. And we also decided that none from the client side would be there on the shoot. So we could see the entire shoot on our television screens or on our laptop screens the entire day, how the shoot went. And there was minimal presence of additional manpower or resources. People, in fact, we had advice to people to bring their own food from their homes. So even the artists, they brought their own food from home. And that's how the entire shoot happened within an 8-hour shift.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Anshul, I was speaking to you and also I've spoken to some other marketers during this 2-3 month period. And they were saying that, you know, they're very happy, you know, that these lockdown ads, which were made from home, were working out at a budget, which was like a fraction of a cost than a regular full-fledged shoot. So, you know, Aggie, I'd like to come to you. You know, are marketers going to be even more stingy when it comes to shelling out for production now because they've seen, you know, a small budget ad made from home. That's easy, right?
I think it's like missing the forest for the trees or being penny wise and pod foolish. By the time it's October, once the results come in and one smart fellow who's gone and done a proper ad and run away with the sales figures, they'll all come back to normal. Because right now, many of them, if they are saying this, I think it's a short-term vision of saying, can I make an ad in this budget? Of course. In fact, I can make an ad in 1/4 of even the budget that's being made now. But those are not boxes to tick, costs and all. All of these boxes exist in a larger box of whether the ad works. If it doesn't work, it doesn't matter how cheap you make it, right? So I would rather spend 100 rupees well than waste 20 rupees. This is how I would look at it.
So you want to say something?
Then how I love him for saying this. Makes absolute sense. It's just so right.
But you know, I'll be honest, Nita, I'm not sure too many people are even saying that. See, I think all said and done, at least, you know, I think people are aware of what the world is going through. I think there is also a deep recognition that, to be very honest, I think because there has been impact on media as well. And media, to some extent, there is original programming which is now coming back on TV. And I think all said and done, I think people are recognizing that let's actually, and that's my experience, people are saying, let's spend a little extra, let's make it look good, let's make sure that the conversation of quality is back on the table. And I think that's actually it's been a huge breather, because in all of this, there is so much conversation about logistics. But as a creative person, it's very scary when there is very little conversation about the quality of the output. That's equally important. Like Aggie said, there's no point in burning away money behind a mediocre product versus saying actually spending and making sure that, you know, you get some good stuff out there.
Yeah, see, it's very simple, right? Would you save 80% of your production budget and lose 0.5% of your market share? Which one is longer?
No, but I think for a lot of marketers, you know, who are not really doing well, there are some sectors who are doing exceedingly well and there are some which are doing badly, right? But they still want to be in the public eye. So they want to keep the engagement going, but profits are not, you know, the same. So they want to cut down. The first casualty is always advertising and they want to reduce the production budget. That's like a natural flow, right? So that's the logic I was told, but I hope that doesn't...
It's not an impossible logic. It's just a wrong logic, because I would rather they don't actually spend anything at all.
Absolutely.
Just wait for when they have money. Because it's like I said, it's if you can't stitch a proper suit of clothes, then don't stitch it. Don't stitch a suit which has short pants. No?
Anshuman, do you agree?
I have a little different perspective. While I agree a lot with what Agnello is saying, it's a kind of a vicious circle. And the issue is that if companies don't have enough revenues at the moment, from where will this money come to make the best impactful ad? And more than that, if the markets are not open, where do you sell your products? So end of the day, one needs to analyze and figure out what is the best solution possible. In fact, let me tell you, it's a great example I must share with all of you. And we faced this challenge, and we realized very quickly in the month of March that our traditional portfolio of fans, home appliances, lighting, and switchgear with the current retail distribution setup might not be able to sell the product. We quickly figured out what really helps us to stay, remain, and engage with our customers. And I believe many brands have done that in the recent scenario. And we therefore figured out something that makes us relevant to stay with our consumers and connected was to make a product which makes their life simpler and safer. And on 18th of this month, we launched a UV Sanitech, which is a UV sanitization box where people can sanitize all their products of daily use. And we did a complete makeover in terms of marketing, in terms of figuring out how we can reach out to the digital mediums. With the limited monies that we had, we produced two films. We looked at rewriting scripts in a way which are simpler. We looked at 3D as a format. We looked at using old footages, other creatives that we can help to make this much more easier and comprehensible for people to work through. And this product is being sold online and doing wonderfully well for the last 4 days. In fact, almost going out of stock every day that I get the report. So I think while I agree with Agnello to a certain extent, the issue is that we don't have money also at the moment to spend in that manner, which we really would like to, but we don't have it.
No, Anshuman, I think
I was responding to the part of a question of Neeta's question where she said many clients are saying, oh, forever now this will be the new cost because we can actually do it so cheap. So we are doing cheap films as well for clients who don't have money. In fact, some of them are so cheap that they're almost free. But we must all recognize that this is a stopgap. It can't be, at least I think towards the end of her question, her clients, she felt that there are clients who are saying, this may be the new budget forever from now on because we didn't know films could be made so cheap. And I think that is flawed logic because you can't take something which is a stopgap arrangement because you have to be alive in consumers' minds and therefore you have to keep going now. But eventually you'll have to start getting stronger as a brand. You can't, if you don't have enough food as a brand as an individual, of course you stay on starvation diet because you have to get by those days, but eventually you have to become stronger. You can't be on starvation diet all your life or you'll remain weak all your life and cause permanent damage to your brand. So it was about that part, about the feeling that this new costing norm could be the permanent new normal in terms of how you make films, because that would then take branding and marketing everything 20 years back.
I completely agree to that effect, Nello. In fact, the only thing that I'd like to add on, and Neeta was asking me before the interview about the costing, I said that the costing of production actually will go up. Now, with the insurance, with the other things coming in, the SOPs coming in, the cost of production is going up. And end of the day, it is not the producers or the directors or the production houses who are going to foot the bill.
It is
the marketer who is going to foot the bill. And eventually the consumer. So in an indirect way, yes. Mm. But the fact is that this is an area where the cost is actually going to go up. Irrespective of the fact in the current scenario, yes, we are looking at small scale films to tide over the situation. But I completely agree with you. That's not a solution for long term. This is only a stopgap solution. For a long term, one needs to have a bigger horizon and look at a larger format to ensure that the brand has far more stability and sustainability.
Even Puneet and Anshuman, I think both touched upon this COVID insurance. Puneet, you want to say something? I'm sorry, I think I just...
Creatively, for us to shoot a film in these times is a nightmare. I mean, I get the whole money aspect of it as well. The clients are also squeezed. But the fact of the matter is, in a lot of ways, our cost of production has also gone that much higher. To sanitize a proper set, if you're actually going onto a set, in today's times, is about 2.5 lakh rupees daily. And that's a daily cost of sanitizing a set. Your expenses have gone higher. I understand you're doing a home shoot is far cheaper. But there is no fun. There is no fun as a creative to sit down and do something at home. You know, you're not, you don't, you miss the nuances. You can't actually direct or do things that you'd like to do. Like Arun said, you're thinking differently. You're not thinking outdoor spaces. You're restricted in every which way. And that's not the best situation to be in. So I guess everybody is squeezed on some level.
But tell me, you spoke about COVID insurance, and of course marketers are footing that bill. Is that happening on a definite basis now? Because otherwise when it came to insurance, in a bit to be competitive, I think that was the first thing to be knocked off. So today, because of the scare of the pandemic, are you necessarily ensuring that every shoot is insured, and what does it comprise?
So you're meant to take care of everybody's medical bills if someone gets COVID on set. You're meant to take care of the entire expenditure in that sense. The insurance is fairly reasonable. It's not something that breaks anyone's back. So everybody's fair in that sense. But like I said, tracing it back to a person is kind of tricky because, most people on ads are freelancers. So let's say they worked on a project a week ago. They come onto your film and you realize that someone's come onto the film with temperature. So right. Even if he's kind of detected on your set, he's not necessarily got COVID on your set.
Right.
So there's a lot of gray area in all of this as well. But I think we are fairly covered by insurance.
Okay. Anushka, let me come to you. You're a very popular influencer. Do you feel, marketers are kind of deviating towards alternatives if they can't shoot as freely at this point? Now, you've endorsed some brands during this lockdown on social media platforms. What do you think? Is that an alternative at this point?
Yeah, I think so. Like for now, because there's lockdown and we can't go out or shoot. So a lot of promotions, a lot of brand promotions, a lot of music videos, promotions I did between this lockdown, that's the work I was doing from home, and a lot of brands. I think this is an alternative for now. I think until the time, we can go out and do the brand promotions. Initially, they used to, call us at a place and have like a nice different location and shoot the promotions, but now it's all from home. And the best part about brand promotions at home for me will be, I'm learning a lot of things because there's no extra crew when you're shooting these kind of stuff because nobody's allowed in my building for now, so we don't have anybody any extra crew. So whatever we are shooting, we're just shooting on our own, me and my parents. My parents are helping me out with that, and all the deliveries, what are there, the dates and whatever the content is, we're all discussing over Zoom calls, and that's how it is working out, which is fun for me. I'm learning new things, and I've never done this before, but I'm doing this right now, and it's quite fun. But of course, for a long period of time, I think I would love to go out and shoot because I really miss doing that. I really miss going out and shooting with new people, with the whole crew and everything. It's been 4 months, so yeah.
I think Puneet is going to like that answer. Anshuman, let me ask you, you had told me that in the entire lockdown period, you had not shot a single ad, but you were, even a lockdown ad, you had refrained from shooting, but you were active on social media throughout. So do you think it's still a safer bet, anyway, social media consumption is hitting the roof, so you can continue to engage people on social media right now?
Yeah, Anita, I completely agree with what you're saying. Social media is becoming even more relevant in current context and will remain and will grow. However, the mainline cannot be ignored, and as things get normal, we will continue doing more of mainline work. In the interim period, we figured out new ways of working. We worked with influencers, tech bloggers, etc. For this launch. We also looked at how we can repackage our own old content, the old footages. We looked at finding out how we can also look at using 3D as a format for creating storytelling and information awareness. So different kinds of stuff that we tried out during this period, including even GIF promotions, which are, non-static format of advertising also. So all that was an attempt to innovate and try out different things to stay engaged with our consumers. And I think that really worked that far. But will that be always a constant? I don't think so. We will continuously evolve and find new ways of engagement. But audiovisual as a content medium will grow, and that will remain a very important medium for communicating with the consumers.
Okay. Arun, I'd like to give you a compliment. you have shown this that you can make a lockdown ad, like on point lockdown ad, and which can go viral for all the right reasons and not looks very similar to the other ones, you know, that other brands are dishing out. I'm talking about the Sumit Vyas ad. So do you think we can continue to make some lockdown ads for a little while longer till we are sure about what happens to the pandemic and still be creative?
So, you know, I just want to correct. So there is a difference, right? So and that was done for a brand called WakeFit, where it wasn't really an ad. So WakeFit is a brand where we've been running, we have a content calendar for the brand where there is continuous content creation that happens through the year. So this was actually when the lockdown happened, that content calendar actually paused, because the content that we were running was an on-ground promotion, and we did something called the sleep internship, which became quite big. And that paused. And we said, okay, if we have to now change the, you know, we have to continue the calendar, how do we now create content? Obviously, with all the lockdown going on. But finally, when you're aware of the core of the brand, which was the whole, it's a sleep solutions company, we said, what is the one thing because of which people are losing their sleep? Because the whole country was losing sleep over various things, right? So we said, okay, that seems like a great peg to create a whole bunch of content. So we created a whole bunch of content led by our, you know, our branded content guy called Sandeep Balan in our firm. And he and his team actually ended up creating about 9 videos. And if I tell Anshuman as a marketer what it cost, he'll be super happy with it. So and it doesn't cost much, but actually we had to work a lot on the craft of it, on making sure that it connects with people. And then of course it took a life of its own and just kept traveling, because I think we probably touched a raw nerve somewhere. So I think that's what happened. But that is not the reality today as we speak. That was the reality about two and a half months ago. As of today, like I said, again, where we will be in 15 days from now, we don't know. But as of today, that's not the reality we're living in. We are actually, people are want, and brands who are seeing merit in being out there are actually wanting to look, feel, sound as normal as they can.
Okay. I'd like to bring Puneet and Aggie here. You know, there are a lot of other factors involved. You know, there are delays due to permission, police permissions, welfare associations, societies being cagey about letting crews enter their, localities. Sometimes last minute crew members are getting infected, difficulty in maybe flying actors off from one state to the other, quarantine rules. So tell me, who is suffering more? I'm not just talking about cost. Overall, you know, is it the creative agency? Is it the marketer, or is it the production house? Puneet, you want to start?
One silent.
I said, I think it's everybody. I think it's unfair for us to say that, you know, this person is suffering and this person isn't. Or let's say, you know, the client is in the production house and isn't. I think everybody is working with a certain kind of restriction. We are not being able to do everything we do normally. And in some way or the other, I think everybody is taking a hit. I'm not being able to employ as many people. I'm guessing the client is not being able to pay us because they don't have enough money. And it's just a circle that's just, you know, getting everybody to suffer. I think all we can do is just pray that this thing happens and it's done with really soon, and everybody gets back to normal. I think that's the only way we can way forward.
Are you learning any new skills? Like, you know, somebody was speaking about remote direction and remote production, you know, having a skeletal staff on ground. Anything that you know, any silver lining of this lockdown?
To be honest, I think the only silver lining is that we've all learned to be patient. There's not much that you can do. Everybody has to be far ahead in terms of technology. You've really got to be, you know, with it to kind of cope with everything that's happening at this point of time. Most shoots were remote shoots for the last 4 months. So everybody really needs to be on top of the game in that sense. But I mean, I'm only hoping this is not the new normal. And this is the new normal only for like about another couple of months. And eventually it will be gets back to normal, you know. Because this is not the new normal. This is not something you want to live with.
Aggie, in the new normal, who's suffering more? Agencies, production houses, or marketers?
I think if you go from the top to the bottom of the food chain, at the very bottom is the actual worker, right? The guy who works on the set. So he may be suffering lesser in value of how much he's hit, but larger in what proportion of his income is. So it will be 100%. But in at the very top, which is marketeers, they may be suffering much larger in value than, say, the salary of a worker who's working on a set. But it won't be everything that they have. So it's in reverse proportion. I think agencies have clients who are on retainer. Some of the clients have reduced the retainer. So there is other media to work on, and you know, other inputs that you give clients for which you get paid for. But the lower down the value chain you go, it will be a lesser amount, but almost everything for that party. So if you go right at the very bottom, it will be, you know, say a guy who's working on a set as a set maker's apprentice, it will be 100% of a set or 90%. So I think it's a tough situation. I think we have to, I just say, let's just live short term and not long term, because the more we look at the scoreboard and the more we look at the larger picture, the less optimistic it seems and demotivating it seems. So it's better to live week by week and see what we are going to do in the coming week or the next 3 days, and eventually it will pass. But there's no point in looking at the finishing line, because the finishing line is not very pretty, nor is it visible.
Anshuman?
Well, I agree with Agnello. In the value chain, while everybody is hit, everybody is under stress in the entire value chain. But the people who are really the workers behind producing this film, the artist, I think they are the most impacted in terms of earnings. And while this reduces further as you go up. What is important here is to understand that while in every industry, there needs to be a level playing field. And I'm very happy with the High Court judgment which came out yesterday, which pronounced that people who are above 60 years of age can now act in films and advertising, which was actually banned earlier. We need to understand the film and the advertising industry is unlike any other industry, where you need child artists, where you need people who are older to portray your story. So I think everybody should have a fair chance to get an opportunity of a livelihood. And this was also a very interesting decision that came yesterday. And I believe that once everybody has an equal chance to gain money and to perform, that's the right approach of bringing back the economy to scale. And that will happen gradually. But I think impact, yes, I agree, it's all through the value chain. But people who really are suffering are the people who are the technicians, the lightmen, the makeup artists, etc., etc.
Arun, would you like to add to that?
No, I think everybody is in a soup, right? Everybody is in a soup. Everybody is trying to find solutions. And I think the more we work on making sure that, you know, that we are keeping the engine running, the better it is for everybody. Because, you know, brands need it, marketing partners need it. Like, you know, all the way down, right? Like, what happens to the technicians? You know, they're hit on it, they're daily wage earners. What do they do? And, you know, the more this engine churns, the better their chances of earning a livelihood. So it is a tough situation. I think everybody is in it together. I think we can just hope that we can keep the engine churning parallelly as the virus fades out of our lives, hopefully, at some point in time. But yeah, I guess that's the only way to go forward.
I like what Anshuman said, you know, they should get a fair chance to work. And, you know, if they can attend weddings, why can't they work for a fair living? So 65 plus and above, I mean. So
again, it's a risky proposition, but they also need to make a living. They also need to, you know, it's one of those things, you know, there's no right or wrong here.
You know, I'd like to ask Puneet and Anushka here, you know, there is, you know, of course, like we all agreed that, you know, the people on the ground are the most affected, you know, also most highly at risk. You know, there is always this stigma and fear associated with COVID. We've heard cases where, you know, doctors were not allowed to enter societies if you have, you know, just for the fear of bringing back COVID to the society. Now, you know, it's not a profession. Production is not a profession like IT, where, you know, you can, you know, give 6 feet space to each and say, you know, just sit in front of your laptops and don't move. Here you have to have human interaction and exchanges, even with the skeletal staff. So how do you deal with that on the sets, Puneet, the emotional quotient? Everybody's scared. Is that going to hamper productivity, creativity?
Productivity for sure. I think, like I said, to give an example, setting days, for example, have doubled. You normally construct a set in 3 days. You now need 6 days. There's that much labor that's coming. So I think on every level, you've got to kind of, evaluate the risk. There are certain things that you can be do from like social distancing. There's certain things you can't, like two actors have to get close to each other on a set. I mean, how do you avoid those things? So I think it's a bit of a calculated risk on, what you can do and what you can't.
Okay. You know, Anushka, you know, I remember reading this interview of, I think, Mahima Makwana. She stars in a serial in Colors, Shubharam, I think. She said, on the set, she experienced severe chest pain. And people, instead of showing some empathy, literally moved away from her, thinking that she has COVID. And then she got a flood of messages on Twitter asking, do you have COVID? Do you have COVID? It doesn't sound really nice and, very correct at that point in time.
Right.
So, Anushka, when you decide to go back on the set, is that something that you'll be afraid of? That people will be insensitive and you might not really get the treatment that you deserve despite putting yourself at risk there?
Correct. I read that interview myself and I was wondering that why people were treating her like that. Because, okay, no matter, of course I understand the risk and I totally agree with everyone that, you're putting yourself at risk. And of course, two actors have to come close to each other and you can't have 6 feet, a distance between each other. But I think no matter what happens, humanity should be there. We should not be insensitive. I think the best possible way to, fight these kind of fears or stigma is that probably, have somebody responsible or have doctors on set or at least one or two people who are, responsible for, something, some kind of incidents, if these kind of incidents happen, so they can take care of, like, for example, if Mahima Makwana was like having sudden chest pain and she sat down and everyone is just running away from her and she's having severe pain there. So I think if there was a doctor or somebody responsible that, because these kind of things are going to happen, not only because of COVID, even before COVID, when I was also shooting, sometimes somebody got sick suddenly or somebody fell and, hurt themselves. But of course, because this COVID is there, I think one doctor or somebody should be responsible and just help people out, because we should not forget humanity and try our best. Because I really salute the doctors and nurses. They are just risking their lives. For 20-25 days they don't return to their houses, to their families, and if they can risk their lives, that too because they're treating somebody. So I think one person can take the responsibility of taking care of the crew and the cast.
That's she telling you to add one more thing on that list. The cost gets increased a little more. Get a doctor on the set.
Little more.
Well, honestly, you can't actually do that at this point of time. Cases all over the city are shooting up in such a big way, right? You cannot actually pull out a doctor to get him on set. As much as it would be needed at this point of time, I don't think it's the most appropriate thing to do to pull a doctor on set. I don't think you the government would permit that either. So, yes, that is the ideal situation. We should have a medical expert on set who can take care of these things. But in the larger scheme of things, I don't think that's possible at this point in time.
And one last question to everybody. After lying low because of, fast drying out cash reserves, because of 2 months of inactivity due to lockdown, of course, lots of brands are suffering. But with festive season, starting next month, do you see marketers coming out to release these big bang ads just ahead of the festive season? Do you think shoes are going to pick up in a big way? Arun?
I think it will, because I think it also depends on category, but I think overall we will see a push when it comes to, because I think the demand has to come back, right? It has to come back, and somewhere there has to be a little bit of a push to propel it. I do see and I do know of brands and even platforms, like the big e-commerce platforms, have big plans for their sales. They all go on sale now because of the festive season. All of it is coming, unless something completely drastic happens in the country where we have to completely close down, which I don't. At this point, it doesn't seem like that's going to happen. But I do see spends going up in the next couple of months. And I think there will be a host of new brands that we will see. which we wouldn't have seen before, which will come into play because of the digital ecosystem actually taking off in the country. And there are a whole host of brands which are going to now start playing there. We will see, and I think the proof is out there, right? We've all seen what's happened to Amazon globally given the pandemic and how much they have grown. So I think that is the reality. So it's going to be interesting, but I do see a positive way forward.
Aggie?
Yeah, I think it's going to be, I'm not sure whether the response will be there from the people, but definitely there's going to be a push from manufacturers and marketers, a very big push in this coming festive season, because anyway, there is a push every year. And this year, I think the push acquires a tinge of desperation. So there will be a big push. I think there will be a more above average response, because I think even people will sense that we've now living comfortably with the pandemic, and they will sense that these are opportunities to buy that they will not get again. So there will be a good enough response. And I can only hope this kickstarts some amount of demand, because with everything that the government is announcing, I don't think there's enough done to generate demand. Until that happens, lowering of taxes, increasing of subsidies, none of that will work until demand is generated. So for me, I think this festive season will actually deliver the answers, because the last thing we want is a huge burst in the festive season and then we go back into recession around November, December.
Anshuman?
Well, I would say that it is a time for cautious optimism. What I understand is that perhaps the worst is behind our back. We would say that the worst that was there is behind our back, because almost 2 months there was no sales happening. While on the retailing end, I find that now the retailers are, the offline retailers are really gearing up. They are preparing with the new normal. There are shields, the visors, the sanitizer in every shop. And gradually we find customers are also keeping it offline. Online, we all know the trends. It is zooming up, and Amazon, Flipkart of the world are obviously gaining. Interesting would be to see how actually consumers consume. But a lot is still desirable, as Agnello mentioned, to bring back the economy on track. Government, everybody has to play a part. I would say that the consumers who were really paranoid 2 months ago are not so paranoid now. They're getting practical and figuring out ways of how they can make their purchases in a very safe and a cautious way. So end of it, I would say that it's a cautious optimism that I could predict at the moment.
Puneet?
Oh, I'm hoping for the better. I completely agree with what Anshuman's saying. I'd like to be optimistic. I'd like to believe that the consumers are going to go out and purchase, or perhaps sit at home and purchase. But I do think that the worst is definitely behind us, and I think it's only going to get better or back to normal.
And Anushka, what do you think? Are you in your case? I think we are hoping that we get to see you in a lot more ads.
We do.
Yeah. Have similar thoughts.
Yeah, of course. You know, when I was just seeing through pictures, it was Mahi Chacha's birthday a few days back. So I was going through the pictures that we took between the ad shoots for Orient that I shot with Anshuman uncle, and I was missing the whole scenario. But I was thinking, wish we could just go back to normal. So I really hope, and I agree with everyone, that we really hope that we go back to normal, or at least we find ways to be safe and go do the things we used to do.
So let me
also, it's very important for us to know that the young of the country are looking at it positively and are optimistic about the future.
Yeah, and let me tell you that Anushka is also our social influencer, and she just received our package of information and product, and I think she is going to do something at her home to produce a small digital film for us.
So yes,
there's a lot of work around. So,
but we also hope that that ad with Dhoni, like Chachu and Chiki ad, goes up on air soon. And you get starting, we start shooting with Puneet on that or whatever.
Yeah, that would be so much fun.
I'm looking forward to it as well, yeah.
Fantastic. So I guess on that note, I hope I can sum up. I believe every adversity teaches us a few things. In this case, like we were discussing, you know, something called collaborative remote production, where some team members are collaborating remotely. Directors are directing over video calls. Some people, skeletal staff on the location. So I guess there are always ways to circumvent the obstacles in the path without really breaking the rules or even compromising on safety. So let's just hope that, you know, we as Indians don't get too creative and start resorting to jugaad, which might not really be in our best interest right now. So thank you. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining me. Puneet, Arun, Aggie, Anshuman, and Anushka. It was great having you on Creative Talks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.